The only wise God, the beginning and the end, the author and the finisher.
We feel
that we are
the
Oh,
Bigger than speakers, we have to hear pastors from different places. So take it seriously. It is not a joke that we are planning, spending money for the flight and visa and just coming here. There is a reason. And it will definitely benefit you people on their vineyard. Amen. I used to say wherever I go, I used to preach what the preachers don't preach. But I preach what the preacher who has already given us very advanced, who is above. And that is what I preach. If you take it, the blessing is with you. Amen. See, I have not seen this kind of crowd, in the sense, not the number of people, the attitude of the people. I've been, as I was reminding yesterday, I've traveled around about 272,000 airlines around the world within the last 45 months. It was not a joke. And the Lord has given me the message, the anointing, where I carry that to wherever I have gone. And I feel like, yesterday when I was doing the sermon, what the Lord has given to me, I have given to you. I cannot just write back without giving you people what the Lord has given to me. But the revelation which came in me was there is a block with each and every one. The block has to be taken away. The block has to be taken away. Without going on this, the first sentence which I said is, be like a child. Don't be like a bishop or apostle or anything. We are just one. I am not greater than you people. I know what you have in your mind. I like to be lower than you do. But what the Lord has given to me, I cannot just keep that in the Bible. I have to give it to you. Amen?
Amen.
So please take it. And during my preaching or teaching or whatever it is, if you have any doubt or you want to clarify something, please, you can get in touch with me through your father. Amen? Because I know that within this short period or short duration, the full description cannot be given. And I am afraid that some occasion when after the meeting and when I go back home with my wife and children, I used to share what was taking place where I was. And we used to cry. Tears used to come in our eyes during our night prayers. That we feel that what has been spoken, have that gone inside you? I am doubt. Because if the Lord Almighty has not opened your mind or your heart, you cannot pray it. So pray that the Lord opens your mind. Amen?
Yes.
So are you ready for today?
Yes.
Are you happy today?
Yes.
Are you happy today?
Yes.
Those who have not come astray. How many of you are there? Those who have not come astray. Amen. So you have missed something yesterday. But today, what the Lord has given to me is something sensitive. Too sensitive. So when I am presenting to you, I make sure that each and every point has to be spoken to you with, because it is too sensitive. And I think that Nigeria, wherever where they say Nigeria, they will, oh, Nigeria, yes. It is not in Dubai I am talking about, it is not in India which I am talking about, it is in African countries. A man I brought from Ghana. I was there just 2 months back. During the meeting, the guest speakers were talking about your country.
Look, my nearer.
Amen. Ghana, in Nigeria, have got something extraordinary which the other African countries doesn't have. And you have not noticed it so far. I want that extraordinary to be used in the divine field. Amen. Instead of using it in some other world and for some other purpose, do it inside the divine world. Let the revival take place from Nigeria. Why can't the revival take place from Lagos? If you are thinking that the revival is not going to take place here, I'm sure it is going to take place in Benin City. Amen. I know why the Lord has brought me here. I know that is the reason. When I go back on the flight, I will be smiling, I will be rejoicing in such a manner. Why the Lord has brought me and what I have seen, what I have tasted. I have to rejoice. Always it happens. This time also, I know that it will happen. So, the only doubt which I have is whether it is going to take place on Lagos or on Benin City. Amen. So, you want to give a pass to Benin City or you want to take it on your own? Amen. Lagos?
Yes.
How are you, Lagos?
Hi.
How old are you? How old are you? 1 3.
Yes.
1 3. Yes. So I don't know whether he got what I was speaking, but he said Lagos. So the smart, as I was just saying, be like a child. Don't feel that we know everything. Even I didn't know everything. What has been revealed to me, I'm just bringing it to you. What has been revealed to you people, I want it. As I said, the man of God was speaking. I've taken some of the things from him. It is the first point for me. Doesn't mean that I'm perfect, 100%. No. I'm just like you people. What is revealed to me, I am speaking to you. So what I really want is, take it. This is something different. And it is something sensitive. Amen? Why I am bringing that, this subject, it's not, I am bringing this subject. It is my Lord who has asked me to speak this subject wherever I go. At least for one session. Because that is the main thing. A person, a prophet. Any prophets out here?
Any prophets here?
Prophet or prophetess? Love. That's right. There are prophets here. I know there are prophets here.
Yes, sir.
It is inside them, but still they doesn't have the confidence to say that bold enough, I'm a prophet. Why? Something is lacking. Why? The prophecy which you are talking, is it what you have received it from above and then given to the people? Or is it based on the person, or based on the person you are talking, saying that it is a prophet, prophecy which is given by the Lord? Then you are wrong. Just keep your mind blank, not the worldly thoughts inside you. Just wait. For a second, if you are a prophet, you will get it and speak directly. It is not necessary to see that person. It's not necessary that he is the big person over here. What the Lord has given to you, he is big. That is why he has been given to you and you are speaking to them. Amen. So, when some prophets speak, the other prophet says, no, 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 he is not a prophet. Why? Because somebody, one of them is actually a prophet, the other one is a false prophet. Amen.
Amen.
Nowadays there are more false prophets which take place. I used to remind everywhere where I go. I was invited in one country, I have not mentioned the country in the church. It was a prophetic international conference. Well, just like this, from different countries. Different prophets have come there, over there. So we were staying in one hotel. My session was on the third day. So the church pastor of that particular host, he is a prophet, that is what he claimed. And during his first 3 days, he was touching 3 persons and was declaring that the Lord has given him the prophecy to declare, to word it to him, that your bank balance will overflow within 2 weeks. Amen? And within these 3 days, he was again declaring to 3 other people that within, because it was during in December, so he said, before the end of that particular year, out of these 3 people, all the 3 people are going to own a private jet. Amen? Do you think that is prophecy? Amen? I'm a prophet. I don't prophesy this kind of things because I don't get this kind of things to prophesy. The Lord God says, be here. Don't go anywhere. Just be here. I'm going to come a second time. And I want you people to come along with me when I come. How many of you are ready for that? You are ready? Oh wow. Today I am going to come with something what the Lord has given to me. And after that, I want your hands to be raised up, saying that you are ready. Amen.
Amen.
So, a prophet, if it is chosen by the Lord Almighty, not by giving a certificate from somebody and saying that he is a prophet. I am not talking about that prophet. I'm talking about a prophet which is being ordained by above, not from the worldly things. Amen?
Amen.
I hope you are getting my points, because you should be getting each and every word which is spoken from this pulpit. You should be knowing well in advance what I'm coming to. Because you are in this field. You are supposed to bring the children of your congregation ready, equipped for the second coming of the Lord. So, as a prophet, what is been received from above, give that. Maybe you feel that, oh, how can I talk this thing to this person? How can he is not that kind of person? But if it is from the Lord, speak frankly. Amen. When it happens, when that prophecy takes place in that particular person, doesn't mean that he has to come and give you thanks. Don't worry about that. But it has been counted by our Lord for what he has given to me, that has been given to you, if it is passed to you, then you are right. Amen?
Amen.
Wow. I don't know how far you are getting it. So, there are people who criticize the divine way which is taking place in the world. Of course, you can criticize. But it should be a healthy criticism. And if you criticize, like a prophet or somebody is preaching or something, a subject, and you can criticize. As I said, it should be a healthy criticism. And if you criticize, if you point out something, if you say that is not right, it is not right, or something, from the word of God, you should be in a position to clarify that. Or you should be in a position to add that particular gift in you. If you have received a gift from above, you as a prophet or as a, by revelation, you can prophesy, or by you are speaking in tongues, you are healing, you are freeing the evil spirits, all this, if you are doing it by the power of the Holy Spirit, you have the right to speak regarding that such things. Because you are experiencing it, you are doing it, and you are tasting it in front of the people. Amen.
Amen.
If you don't have any of this, please be quiet. And pray that I want that gift. Once you receive that particular gift, then you will find what criticism was going through your mind. You will correct during that time. Oh, I was mistaken. I was thinking about something else. But now when I receive that gift, when that is happening in front of me, now I realize what that man of God was doing was right. Amen.
Amen.
So wait until that time. So don't wait for a long time. The time is very short. Immediately, you can't receive these gifts. You can't do this kind of sermon in front of the churches and wherever you go. If you go through my video clips in the YouTube and Facebook and all, I think most of them, they invite me going through them because I don't see anybody. I just know your man of God. Just hardly we have a communication, hardly 1 month, 1.5 months or something like that. He just asked me whether I will be able to come for this meeting. So we were discussing some technical reasons and all this, and then I said, okay, I'll come. But technical reasons for me, getting a visa to come to Nigeria was some difficulties were there during the embassy problems were there. But when the door was open, I just gave information that my visa is stamped, everything is confirmed, I am coming on so-and-so day, by so-and-so flight, I am here. So that I don't mind who is inviting me. I don't mind who is sitting in front of me. The only thing what I mind is what the Holy Spirit has given to me. Before I leave, I have to share it with you people. Amen.
Amen.
You are ready?
Yes.
As I told you from the beginning, it's a sensitive subject. Because I have the right to speak, for I am tasting the gift. Amen.
Yes.
If I am not tasting the gift, if I don't have the gift, I will not be speaking in that manner. Because I wait till that has been revealed to me. That's what from the very beginning I am saying. I don't say that I am an expert in the biblical things. I know those people are in front of me are more expert than me. They know more than me regarding the Bible words, the sense, the history, all that. I agree. But the subject which I am going to talk is not for Nigeria alone. I am talking to the world. Amen?
Amen.
Now we say that we are anointed. We have been anointed by the Holy Spirit. Manifestation of the Holy Spirit. What do you mean by anointing? And what do you mean by manifestation of the Holy Spirit? What is it? And what is Holy Spirit? We say the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Is that so? So how does the Holy Spirit come inside us? How does the Holy Spirit work among us? And how do you recognize it? How do you identify it? And we say, oh, he is an anointed person. He's a man of God. He's an anointed person. But how do you say that? With what authority are you saying that? What do you find different from the other man to this man? To say that he is an anointed person. Amen? Are you getting me?
Yes,
so, I want you people to just each and every word has to be noted. Even the full stop and the comma is important. It is not like a story which I am talking. I want you to understand.
Not to them that believe, but to them that believe not. But prophesying
one. Read that once again, word by word. Therefore,
tongues are for a sign.
What do you mean by tongues? Or which version is that?
Tongues.
Okay. Tongues are
for a sign.
For sign.
Not to them.
Not for
them.
Them
that believe.
That believe.
But to them that
believe. So the tongues are not for those who believe. Are you getting me? Tongues are not for believers. In short, are we believers? Amen?
Amen.
What happened? I told you, the subject is very sensitive. But the word of God says that the tongues are not for believers. So we are believers or non-believers? How many of you are believers here? So all are believers. So the word of God says, I didn't bring anything special from Dubai. The word of God, the Bible is with you, and I have asked somebody to read it from the Bible and says, the tongues are not for believers. And before that it says, therefore, there is something else before that. I'm coming to that. So tongues are not for believers. Amen? What the cross question me? Let me finish it and then you'll find out. So tongues are not for believers, then what happens?
But to them that believe not.
But I think you have to read some other version. The tongues are for non-speaks in tongues. You, of course, I chose to speak in tongues. But in the churches, during the church meeting, they speak in tongues. In Dubai, we have hardly 2 hours or 2.5 hours each, every church. They hire a hall in the same compound, around about 120, 136 halls are there. Around about 200, 250 churches are there. Amen? But here you find the tongues are not for believers, but for non-believers. So what is happening? Where exactly is that happening? So when somebody speaks in tongues in a church, in a congregation, if the pastor doesn't speak in tongues, maybe a member of the church speaks in tongues, people of the remaining members of the church, they give more importance to the person who speaks in tongues. Amen? Why? They say that he's been anointed by the Holy Spirit. By the Holy Spirit to you, we change it. We take it the best one. It is not the best one, but we compare with the Word of God. If what the Word of God says so, we take it. Amen? So what is spoken today, don't take it just because Walto from Dubai is speaking to you. No. What has been spoken today, just refer with your Bible. To refer your Bible, that is why I am asking somebody to read from the Bible. Amen. So where did you get the tongues? Amen. So here it says tongues are not for believers and it is for non-believers. But it says it is a gift, as I told, and it's mentioned in the Bible. It is a gift, one of the gift. But one of the gift in the sense, I hope most of them speaks in tongues. Amen? Yes. How many of you speaks in tongues? Out of this group, you speak in tongues. So, I just want to ask you, when did you receive that particular gift? She says she received the gift of speaking in tongues 2 years back. Okay, and what about you? Last year. Those who have received the tongues more than 10 years, 15 years, 25 years, 30 years, amen. Am I your brother? Sure. I treat wherever I go, all are my family members. So I talk freely to them. And I want you people to take it in that sense. Amen? So, have you received the interpretation of the tongue? Interpretation of the tongue. You have received the tongue. So you have received the interpretation of the tongue? No. Anybody over here who has the gift of interpretation of tongue? You have. Amen. So you can identify what to speak. And you can confess what they speak. Amen. you speak in tongues also. You interpret also. When did you see that?
Leave Jerusalem, you should be here until you receive that particular gift. And while they were there, during a Pentecostal festival, people from around the world, they came for the festival, they were there. But already the followers were there in a house over there. So one fine day, there was a sound from that house, smoke was coming out. So people who came for the festival saw this incident, they ran to that particular house. When they ran there, they saw that tongues divided in two. It's coming out to these people who are sitting inside the house. After seeing that, they heard some voice. They heard that they were speaking something. They were speaking something which they were not able to understand in the beginning. So they were just close to them to find out what exactly they were speaking. So the people who came for the Pentecostal festival, they are from UK, US, Ghana, Nigeria, different areas of the world. They have different languages. So when he was just noticing, one of them said, no, that person is talking my language. How come? He is a local man. How is he speaking in my language? The other person, his friend, was saying that, no, I am from South Africa, he is speaking my language. Other person, I am from UK, he is speaking from my language. So, all those who were present during that time, they were speaking in some kind of tongues, which the people who rushed to that particular place, they were able to follow it. Amen? But nowadays, when we say that we have received a tongues, but when we speak, does anybody follow it? Amen? Is that the same tongue which we are talking about? Amen? It is the same tongue. It's a gift. During the time the tongue, that gift was given to them because during the Pentecostal meeting, the festival, around the world, all believers have come over there for the festival. So they are speaking different languages. So what the Holy Spirit gave to these people was to speak in tongues when all these people can understand what they speak. Amen. But the local people were not in a position to understand. Because they were saying that, no, they are not speaking something else. They might have gone to the bar or they have drunk something and they are coming here and they are speaking. Amen? So it is not that. But the others, the foreigners who came there, they said, no, they are speaking in another language. So it is tongues. Amen? I'm just making sure. Can you read for me the chapter 2 verse 5? Acts.
And they were dwelling at Jerusalem, Jews, devout men, out of every nation under heaven.
Okay, that's what I was saying. Out of every nation they came here and they were listening to what they were speaking. And when Peter stood up among the 11, and he was speaking to these people, and they understood. And he was saying that we did not drink anything, it's too early. Amen? Are you getting me? So, during the time, the first gift came.
When they had this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus.
No, that's it. During that time, chapter 19 verse 5, it says, when the followers of Jesus Christ were there at that spot, when they were there, they were saying about baptism by water. John baptized with water. And we churches also do that the same thing. When the man of God laid his hand on them, they started to speak in tongues. And then again the second gift says prophecy. Amen. During that time they received two gifts. One is tongues, one is prophecy. Amen. So during the power of the Holy Spirit, when the power of the Holy Spirit takes place, when the anointing takes place in you, and the manifestation takes place in you, when you receive this particular gift, you will receive the tongue as well as say that you are anointed because you have the gift of prophecy also. But the people gave more importance to tongues. Amen.
Amen.
1 Corinthians chapter 14 verse 1. There it says, you are supposed to have tongues, but eagerly pray that you receive the gift of prophecy. So why is it our churches don't teach about prophecy? Or they doesn't give more importance for prophecy? Amen? Because they see that most false prophets are already in the world. So when I am a prophet, if I come and speak, maybe they feel that I am also a false prophet. Amen? If you are receiving it from the Lord and you are prophesying to a person, why are you afraid? You can speak. So once, when the Holy Spirit comes in, when the anointing of the Holy Spirit comes in, when you receive that anointing, you will start getting the gifts. So, tongues is a gift, prophecy is a gift, healing is a gift, casting away of evil spirit is a gift, revelation is a gift. Amen?
Amen.
Are you getting me? So, somebody speaks in tongues doesn't mean that that is the power of the Holy Spirit. Yes, it is the power of the Holy Spirit. But still, most of the people, they speak in tongues, but it is not what they have received from above. Because they know that what they speak, they cannot understand. They know that the friend who is nearby you or the church cannot understand that. So they can speak. And there is no interpreter, so they don't speak also. They cannot interpret. And your church, you said somebody speaks in tongues, so you can interpret. If that is the case, means in your church, if somebody speaks in tongues, are you interpreting? You are doing that. All the tongues are truth. All the tongues which are spoken in your church is 100% right? No. Amen. So I'm just talking what exactly you got an evidence here. Amen? So it is not, people can talk in tongues. All tongues, what they say, they claim, it is not from the Holy Spirit. Because we cannot identify, we cannot interpret, so we feel, oh okay. If he talks too long, we say that it's the gift of the Lord. No. Be careful. So make sure, when you receive the tongues, it is from above, not from the worldly thoughts. In some cases, I have heard about that, people used to record the tongues, go home, learn it by heart, and then they come and go and say,
amen.
Don't speak against the Holy Spirit. Amen. You claim that you are received by the power of the Holy Spirit, the gift of tongue. And if it is not from there, you are speaking against the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
You are getting me.
Yes, sir.
And in 1 Corinthians chapter 14 verse 1 onwards, it says, eagerly pray that you get the gift of prophecy. Amen. Amen. I was not able to give you a deep into that, but the points I have just pointed out to you. So, why is this being spoken today? As the leader of the church, as the head of the church, as the appointed person of the church, make sure your followers, your church members, you have different churches, branches, make sure they doesn't misuse the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen? If you start misusing and without identifying that, and if you are the leader of the church will be growing not according to the power of the Holy Spirit, it's according to the worldly power of the Holy Spirit. Amen? I hope you are getting it.
Yes, sir.
So, what I want you people to know is, I want that particular gift. I want that particular anointing. I want that particular gift, what the Lord wants me to carry. How many of you are ready for that? Amen?
Yes.
I don't want the falsehood. I want what the Word of God says. The gift from above, not from the worldly thoughts. Amen? Be on your feet. Be on your feet. Be prepared. Pray inside you. I want that gift. I want that power, the anointing. And I think that the Holy Spirit has been spoken right now. I want that power. If you are ready, you'll be able to receive that. This instant or the next near instant, you'll be able to see the gift of what is taking place in front of you. Do you believe that?
Yes.
Amen.
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 Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Be ready. Close your eyes. Your connection is not with the church over here. Your connection is with the Holy Spirit. Your connection is the Lord Almighty. You and the Lord Almighty. Nobody else. Not your neighbor, not your church, not your pastor, anybody. Now, you and your God. Nobody else. Be prepared. Be prepared for that. Amen. Those who really want to receive it right now, before leaving this meeting. Yes. You want to receive it? Are you sure? Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Raise your hand. You and the Lord Almighty will be a single thing. And we learn the desire in you as to build up. I want that power. I want that power. Pray. Pray that you want the power. Let the Lord touch you. It's not me who is giving you. It's the Lord Almighty. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, receive. In Jesus' name. Pray inside you. Your mind, soul, body. You and your Lord, nobody else. Those who are ready to receive. Those who are ready to receive. Yes. Connect just the Lord, not the worldly thoughts. Don't think about anything else. Not more worldly thoughts. Except the Lord Almighty. He wants to pour you with all of those. Father, and of the Son, and of the
God says, be prepared for it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, receive in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. The Lord God says, yes, something different. What you have not tasted so far. The Lord says, I'm going to fill you up with that. Are you ready to receive it? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, receive in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 What you are holding is not enough. The Lord God says, I want to fill you up to the grave. Are you ready to receive? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, receive in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 In the name of the Father, taste what the Lord has given to you. You have not tasted it so far. The Lord says, just taste me. Once you have tasted the taste, you will never leave it. That's what the Lord says. Be prepared to receive it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, blessing in Jesus' name. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, blessing in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Yes. Be prepared, your mind, soul, body, to Jesus Christ and nobody else. Your mind, body, soul, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, receive
right.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Receive! In Jesus' name, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Receive! In Jesus' name, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Receive! Right now. In Jesus' name, amen.
in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name.
Who blessed the most day?
Which day? On Sunday or Tuesday? On Tuesday. So who is hosting out on Sunday? This Sunday, you are here already.